It's light source.
This day we brought him the bridal veil, and simply because it touches from the top to the bottom, it automatically makes it a collar. It's also known as a ribbon formation for like millions of years. That mud turned to stone. The minerals in it was just right to make it turn to stone. And when the mud dried and left a whole bunch of cracks in it, just like a dry riverbed. And about 10,000 years ago, there was another set of earthquakes, and it shook all these funny shapes onto the ground. These guys are called hex blocks, and they're 320 million years old. Now, this is fossilized mud, so if you want to touch it, you can. It actually feels softer than a regular rock.
Fall onto it, it dries and forms it into a bigger rock, so it's basically like a sleeve.
Very good. Excellent. The cave is also made up of limestone, and limestone has calcite in it. So when the water's dripping through the ground, it's eating away at the limestone and depositing calcite onto the walls and the ceilings and the ground. And the different colorations are the minerals that come from the soil. But that was excellent. Did you guys study this?
Nope.
No? Oh man, you're like just super smart. All right, y'all teach me. Come on. All right.
It's a rock formation that forms from the ceiling and goes down.
From the ceiling and goes down, and stalagmites grow from the ground up. One day if they meet, it's going to form a what?
Column.
Why? What am I doing with my life?
All right,
you had yours up.
There's a needle on our hand, and when you touch it, it'll stop growing. I quit.
Everybody come back.
You don't know what else to teach them. They know it all. Y'all got any questions for me? No? All right, let's go look at the castle. You can touch him all you want.
Thank you.